Hello everyone and welcome back to Talk Tuesday.
Going up on the Tuesday.
Today for Talk Tuesday, I actually have a very interesting topic for you guys. We're going to be talking about the truth of Christopher Columbus. I feel like a lot of people don't really know the truth about Christopher Columbus, and I feel like people really need to know the truth about Christopher Columbus. So as promised in a previous live stream, I think, today I will be dragging Christopher Columbus. So first of all, this is still a national holiday in America, Christopher Columbus Day. And I don't think many understand Christopher Columbus was literally ruthless. He was worse than today's ISIS. He was that bad. And honestly, you'd have to be a monster to want to celebrate this guy and his day. And you know, if you didn't know this, it's okay. We're taught in school, Christopher Columbus in 1492 sailed the ocean blue, all that BS. And so I want to tell you about why this guy was, why we should no longer celebrate his holiday in this country. A lot of schools don't even celebrate it anymore. I know most people don't get the day off or anything. It's not even a good holiday. And I'm pretty sure most schools still have school. I saw the miserable neighbor next door walking to the bus yesterday morning. So here in America, we've been celebrating Columbus ever since the 18th century because he was the one who discovered America. Wrongo. Christopher Columbus was an Italian explorer who was sent on a mission to find gold, and he was actually trying to get to the East Indies. And he actually never even set foot in the upper 48 states of America. Like, he never even made it to Florida. The dude landed in the Bahamas, actually, and thought it was the East Indies. It actually was Haiti, I think he specifically landed in. Now, there was a reward set by him for the first person to discover land or see land from the boat. Now, another sailor was the first one to see the life of the Bahamas. He was the first one to claim this prize. However, Christopher Columbus, a day later, said, "No, actually, I saw it last night. I saw a dim light in the distance last night. So no money for you, money for me." And that reward was 10,000 maravedis, which is actually about like 500 bucks today, which may not seem like a lot, but back then that was about a year's salary for a sailor. So he totally gypped that guy. But it gets much worse. He thought he was landing in the East Indies. And when he landed, he was greeted by tons of native people. Now, the native people that were living in America that Columbus would come across over time, so he didn't meet all these tribes at once, but the main ones were the Arawaks, the Lucayans, and the Tainos. Now, I hope I'm saying that right. I really struggle with words, so. When he first got there, the native people greeted him, and they were actually super, super nice. They were not hostile. They were greeting them as in like, welcome to our land. They were sharing everything they had. They were so kind. Columbus started calling them the Indians because he thought he was in the East Indies. He literally didn't know that the continent of North America was there. He thought he was gonna go straight through all the way to the East Indies, and clearly he didn't go nearly as far as he thought. Now clearly we know that since there are people living there, he was not the person to discover America. In fact, not even close. The Vikings had been there about 500 years earlier. Leif Erikson had been there before and basically left because he realized it was already inhabited. But in reality, Columbus was really a thief of America. He took it from the people that lived there, and it was brutal. In his diary, he wrote that they were handsome, smart, and kind people. In fact, he specifically said this: "They offered to share with anyone, and when you ask for something, they never say no. Their Arawaks didn't really have a lot of weapons, they didn't have prisoners, they didn't have criminals. They were a very peaceful community. It was all built around loving one another and sharing." Sounds like we need a little bit of that today. Can you imagine if America just like stayed in their ownership? But no, Christopher Columbus had to come fill up. They were so kind-hearted that when Christopher Columbus' ship, the Santa Maria, started sinking, they labored for hours trying to save his people and save the ship. They helped save all their cargo and everything, and they were such honest people that everything that they saved, brought out of the water and brought back to them, was still there. And Columbus wrote about this in his diary, how wonderful they were, how nice they were. And you'd think that maybe he was writing this to say, you know, how great, how wonderful these nice, kind people here to welcome us and help us. No. He basically was writing all that in his diary to show that they were just idiots. In his eyes, they were morons. This was going to be an easy steal of this land, that he would easily be able to take them out because they were so trusting and unfamiliar with war. He himself said that they were built well, with good bodies and handsome features. They do not bear arms, and they do not know them, for I showed them a sword, and they took it by the edge and cut themselves out of ignorance. They have no iron. And he was really on a mission to find gold, but what he realized quickly is there wasn't as much gold there as he thought there was. And so he decided that he was going to change his mission up a little bit. And his real reason for being there, other than to get gold, which he did want to do as well, was to bring home slaves, which he said was worth just as much as gold. Their spears are made of cane. They would make fine servants. With 50 men, we could subjugate them all and make them do whatever we want. Here there are so many of these slaves. Although they are living things, they are as good as gold. And he was so impressed by how loving and kind this community was that he immediately seized their land for Spain and murdered, raped them, and stole everything that they had. He killed many of them, any that were useless. He would save all the men and women that were still able to work and put them as slaves in gold mines. With only 2 years of being there, he killed off about half the population, about 125,000 people, were dead in 2 years. He said that the way that they were so full of love and not greed made them easier to enslave. There were so many rapes of women, it's unbelievable, including little girls. In fact, girls from around 10 to 12 years old were perfect for him. He would enslave them as sex slaves. He would even reward his men for good work by giving him a woman to rape. In his journals, he would talk about how he would break women down by raping them over and over and over again until they were basically willing to do whatever he wanted them to do, or they just killed themselves. He also robbed everything that they had. Eventually, he started this whole tribute system where he would have natives that were 14 years or older start working in gold mines right away, and they would have to fill a hawk's bell with gold. And if they didn't, every 3 months do this, he would cut their hands off. That's ISIS level stuff. Not only that, he would hang their hands around their necks, and most of the time they just bled out immediately. And if you did get enough gold, you were safe for 3 months and could continue working until the next, you know, hand chop off ceremony. There was a man named Bartolome de las Casas, I hope I'm saying that right, but he was one of Columbus's men. He eventually like had a come to Jesus moment, literally became a Catholic priest and really, really talked about how brutal everything was. And he said that this tribute system for gold was absolutely intolerable and impossible. He eventually started the transatlantic slave trade, where he would take the best fit natives and ship them back to Spain on boats. Most of the people died on the boats on the way there due to the terrible conditions he put them in. And the rest of the people there that weren't of use to him, he basically murdered for fun. There was tons of bizarre things that they did to these people. One of them being they would test their swords by cutting people in half to test the sharpness of them. He would behead them, torture them. It was absolutely brutal. He would even kill people by putting them into boiling vats of soap. From some of the journal entries of the men, we know that they would take newborn babies right off the breast of a woman and smash their heads against a rock, kill them, and feed them to their dogs. In fact, many people were used as dog food. Not to mention that, he also started a global child sex slavery ring that is probably still lingering on today. As we all know, it's still alive and well, sex trafficking. But he would sell children off around the world. Eventually, he went back and came back to the New World. He brought cannons and attack dogs and would let these dogs hunt people down, anyone who's trying to escape slavery or leave. He would literally let these dogs rip their bodies apart while they screamed. If any of the natives resisted slavery, he would cut off their nose or an ear or some other body part, do something ridiculous to them. So many of them who just didn't want to be slaves, didn't want to go live this terrible life, resorted to suicide. Tons of them, there were suicide packs, there were mass suicides, taking poisons, all kinds of stuff. Women would literally kill their newborn babies with their bare hands to save them from having to live this miserable life, or, you know, something worse happening to them, getting chewed up by a dog or something crazy. So they would literally kill their babies and then normally kill themselves. He brought disease with him that killed a lot of the natives. There is a rumor that, if you've ever heard this, it's not true. I want to put it out there that he like covered blankets in smallpox and opened a bedding store and like made everyone sick. That has been debunked. That was not a real thing, just so you know. But he might as well have done that, because everything else that he did was so much worse. Bartolome de las Casas, the one who became a priest, actually said this about one of the days there. The Spanish soldiers dismembered, beheaded, or raped 3,000 native people. Such inhumanities and barbarisms were committed in my sight as no age can parallel. My eyes have seen these acts so foreign to human nature that I now tremble as I write. Experts think that around 3 million people were living on the islands when they first arrived. And 20 years after Columbus first arrived, there were only 60,000 left. Let that sink in. 3 million to 60,000. Within 50 years of his arrival, not a single original native person was left on the island. Not a single one. The entire population has been wiped out. There's not a single person who has full blood of the native tribes that he came across. Eventually, Christopher Columbus was actually arrested for his behavior and taken back to Spain in shackles. He was actually pardoned for his crimes, but you know, he lived the rest of his life out there. So this guy, apparently a hero who discovered America, literally the end of his life ended in arrest, and he was responsible for the murders, rapes, and suicides of millions of people. And if you didn't know this stuff, you must be asking yourself, why do we still celebrate this guy? It's okay if you didn't know it, now you know, you know? I mean, a lot of people don't know this stuff because we get a version of everything in school. Now, personally, I think this should remain a holiday, but it should be a holiday to respect and celebrate the native people of this land. Hawaii has already renamed it Discovered Day. South Dakota calls it Native American Day, but it is still celebrated in many places. There are still, you know, lesson plans involving Christopher Columbus, and this kind of education still goes on about this horrible man. There's a huge mural in Congress still hanging there to this day of Christopher Columbus. If you really think that after hearing all of the stuff that I just told you that is absolutely fact, something's wrong with ya. Just gotta say it. But that is the truth about Christopher Columbus. He also, to be honest with you, was not very smart, did not really know when it came to any of this stuff. I don't even know how he ended up being the leader of this. But yes, Christopher Columbus has now been